Hi there, I'm Dr. John Carrasso, child psychologist and executive director of the Autism Center of Pittsburgh and Autism Link. Welcome to Dr. C's Morning Minute. It's great to have you here. Today, I'll be talking about the prognosis or outcome of children with mild autism. You know, I've been espousing for years that children with mild autism can and often do demonstrate substantial progress and, in a few years, no longer meet diagnostic criteria for an autism diagnosis. Now, finally, I have some backup besides my own clinical experience. What we have is new research findings in the Journal of Child Psychology and Psychiatry that looked at 34 children who were diagnosed with autism, but later in life functioned as well as their neurotypical age mates. Now, some may ask, was the initial diagnosis inaccurate? No, it wasn't. The researchers found that, in fact, the initial diagnosis, autism diagnosis, was accurate and appropriate. Okay, is this a common occurrence? Well, obviously, entirely losing the diagnosis may not be commonplace, but it's more common than some practitioners believe and more common than many parents are typically told. In fact, a 2007 study in the Journal of Autism and Developmental Disorders also found that symptoms of autism tend to improve over the course of time. The reasons why some children's symptoms subside is not entirely clear. It would seem that early intervention is vital, of course, as well as treatment that is intensive, comprehensive, and implemented by competent practitioners. However, ultimately, as was explained by Dr. Insel, who's the director of the National Institute of Mental Health, who funded this study, his quote, "Although the diagnosis of autism is not usually lost over the course of time, the findings suggest that there is a very wide range of possible outcomes," end quote. Now, that reality and hope is what I, and of course parents with whom I work, hang our hats on. Okay, I too have found that children with mild signs of autism respond very favorably to treatment and can be indistinguishable from their age mates after a few years. Moreover, even in the case of more severe symptoms, ongoing progress is the norm and it clearly justifies intensive support and treatment. So, given all of these realities and factors, it's vital to never give up the fight against those entities that interfere with children receiving all they need to reach their fullest potential. Fight to keep your child's services. Ensure your child's treatment staff is experienced and competent, and keep informed of all treatment options. First, feel free to contact me at the Autism Center of Pittsburgh at 1-855-HOPE-360 to discuss your child's treatment and ask any further questions. Now, I hope you found this post to be helpful and heartening. God bless. I'll see you next time on Dr. C's Morning Minute. Bye-bye now.